Hi all. Myhill-Nerod theorem, or also called as table filling method, is used for minimization of DFA. Basically, it contains three steps, which are these three. If you don't understand these three steps, don't worry, I'll explain it while solving the problems. But as of now, just make a note of it somewhere or take a screenshot, because I'll be erasing them to solve the problems. Now let us solve a problem using Myhill-Nerod theorem. The question is, minimize this following DFA using Myhill-Nerod theorem or table filling method. To solve this problem, the basic step is to draw a transition table. In our question, there are four finite states, which are A, B, C and D, and there are two input symbols, A and B. A and B. The transition table is A, B, C and D, and two input symbols. If we look at our DFA, A on A goes to A, so A on B goes to C, B on A goes to D, B on B goes to A, C on A goes to D, and similarly, C on B goes to A, D on A goes to B, D on B goes to D. So this is our transition table, and after completion of transition table, let us implement the steps which I have told you previously. And the initial state and final state are A itself. So this arrow mark represents the initial state and star represents the final state. Now let's implement the step one, which is, in our DFA, we have four finite states, which are A, B, C, D. So let us construct this A, B, C and D, and draw like this, A, B, C and D. Ignore this last one, first one here, and draw like this. Now step one is completed, that is drawing this table, and the step two, let us implement the step two, which is marking the states or the cells. Now let us consider this cell BA or AB. Step two says that if any one of the state belongs to final state and other state does not belong to final state, then mark this cell. Now let's see BA. Now B is non-final state and A is final state, so mark BA. Now CA or AC. Now C does not belong to final state and A belongs to final state. That is, one state belongs to final state and other state does not belong to final state, so mark CA. Similarly CB, if you look at this, both are non-final state, but our condition is only one should belong to final state and other should not belong to final state. So this fails the condition, so leave it as it is, don't mark it. And DA, if you look at this, D and A is belongs to final state, D does not belong to final state, so mark it. Similarly DB, D does not belong to final state and B also does not belong to final state, so leave it. DC, D also does not belong to final state, C also does not belong to final state, so leave it as it is. After step 2, the table looks like this. Now let us implement the third step in Myhill-Nerod theorem. Now after step 2, we have the table as this one, and These three are unmarked cells. Now let us consider the unmarked cell CD. So we have two input symbols A and B in our DFA. So consider delta of C on A, delta of D on A, which is C on A, which is D, and D on A, which is B. And similarly for input symbol B, delta of C comma B equals to A, and delta of C, sorry, delta of D comma B equals to D. After doing this, we have DB. So check if DB cell is marked in this table or not. So we have DB as here, which is unmarked. So leave it. Now AD. Check if in this table AD is marked or not. AD is marked. If any one of them is marked, then mark this cell CD. I'm telling it again. Check DB. D and B in this table. It is unmarked. So leave it. AD. AD is marked in this table. If any one of them is marked, then mark this cell CD. So mark CD. Similarly, for other unmarked cells, we'll do this. For DB, we have D and B here. So B. Delta of B comma A equals to D, and delta of B comma B equals to A. So D and A. Now repeat the same process. DB. Check if DB is marked or not. DB is unmarked, so leave it. Check if AD is marked or not. AD. AD is marked. So mark this cell DB. Similarly for BC. Now delta of C comma A is D, and delta of C comma B is A. Now check if DD is marked in this table or not. We don't have DD, so leave it. AA. We don't have AA in this table, so leave it. So as both of them are not marked, so leave this as it is. So BC remains unmarked, and these two states which were unmarked in the step 2 are marked now in the step 3. Now step 3 is completed and we have the table like this. Now the ultimate aim of this table filling method or Myhill-Nyro theorem is to minimize the DFA. Minimization of DFA can be done by using this table. We have done all this process, created this table based on our given DFA, and minimization of VFA can be done by grouping the similar states. We have 4 states in our given DFA. A, B, C, D, and we have constructed this table. In Myhill-Nyro theorem, we identify the similar states based on this table. We see that all these cells are marked except this cell, which is BC or CB. Now, Myhill-Nyro theorem states that after completing of step 3 in this table, if we have any unmarked cell, that is BC in this BC or CB in this table, group these states. That means B and C are similar states. Initially, our DFA was A, B, C, D. All these states were independent, but according to this table, now B and C are together. That means B and C are similar states. So group them together. Now our DFA becomes like this. Now let us construct the complete DFA by drawing the transitions. Now B and C are grouped together. So A, B comma C. डी ए इज इनिशियल एंड फाइनल स्टेट, सो इनिशियल एंड फाइनल स्टेट. नो ए ऑन ए गोज टू ए, ए ऑन बी गोज टू सी, बी ऑन ए गोज टू डी, बी ऑन बी गोज टू ए. सिमिलरली सी ऑन ए गोज टू डी, सी ऑन ए गोज टू डी, बट ऑलरेडी वी हैव ड्रॉन दिस सी ऑन ए गोज टू डी, सो इग्नोर दिस. सी ऑन बी गोज टू ए, सी ऑन बी गोज टू ए, ऑलरेडी इट इज प्रेजेंट सो लीव इट. डी ऑन ए गोज टू बी, डी ऑन ए गोज टू बी, डी ऑन बी गोज टू डी. Now this is the minimized DFA. We have constructed the minimized DFA using Myhill-Nerode theorem. Now let us see some more examples on Myhill-Nerode theorem.